Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Corpsalot coming to you with a really quick video. Probably not, but I'll try. Lately, Blizzard has been making some haboo, some hubbub on the interwebs. Oh man, it's one of those days, huh? Well, this is nothing new, actually. For those of you who have been following the beta for Warlords of Draenor, You'll know most of these things, most of the changes that are going through. And I briefly touched on this on my last show on this past Friday. But I see a lot of posts coming up about this, and I figured I'd like to put my two cents in about this topic. The topic is dot snapshotting, as you could probably tell by the title of the video. Now, there's a lot of people out there who are very upset that Blizzard is getting rid of dot snapshotting. Now you're probably wondering, Corpslot, what the hell is dot snapshotting? Or snapshotting in general? Well, basically how it works is, currently in the game, in World of Warcraft, when you have a dot that you can put on a target, whether you're an Affliction Warlock, a Shadow Priest, a Moonkin, what have you, if there's a dot that you can put up on the target, typically what you want to do is you want to put those dots up. You want to make sure you refresh your dots on the target when certain buffs and trinkets proc, when certain conditions are met. So what you'll do is you'll run a bunch of add-ons to monitor your dot timers and monitor your buffs and whatever else is going on. And when the conditions are right, when the planets align in just the right way so that you have every buff, every trinket, everything is going full force, then and only then will you put your dots up on the target or refresh your dots up on the target. And then, even if those buffs and the trinkets wear off, even if those things, you know, they time out, they're no longer applying themselves, the dots you had up on the target still maintain their power. Well, Blizzard's getting rid of this. Blizzard said, no more dot snapshotting. The dots you have up on the target are going to change automatically when you get buffs, and they're going to automatically get weaker when you lose your buff. So it's no more of this, the dot that's up on the target remembers the condition it was when it cast it. When you casted it, it's going to change dynamically based on how much spell power or whatever buffs you have, things of that nature. Well, this has a lot of people in a tizzy, because apparently, this is the dumbing down of World of Warcraft. Now, let's be fair, okay? If anything is a huge dumbing down of World of Warcraft, I could point fingers at things like the Dungeon Finder, you know, things of that nature. The Quest Tracker, you know, those things I would be more inclined to point at as the official dumbing down of the video game. But okay. So their argument is that because Blizzard is getting rid of snapshotting, the game is getting dumber. Why? Because only the most pro of pro gamers in World of Warcraft, well, they were the ones who really timed their dots. You know, Affliction Warlock, anybody can play an Affliction Warlock, but only the pros, only the pros knew when to cast the dots because the add-on they had installed told them so. The pros, guys. It's all about the pros. And you might say, Corpslot, you sound awfully condescending about that. I am, because it's fucking retarded. I played an Affliction Warlock since the Burning Crusade. Alright? I had an Affliction Warlock in the Burning Crusade, and all the way through Burning Crusade, Wrath of the Lich King, Cataclysm, and then even into Mists of Pandaria, which is when I was really like, you know what, I'm pretty much done. I hated Pandaria. I hated Pandaria. I hated Cataclysm even more, but Pandaria, I hated Pandaria. It was so boring. Anyway, that's besides the point. I played Affliction for a long time. I did a lot of raiding, guys. I did a lot of raiding. I did a lot of dungeoning. I even did PvP at one point. And you know what? At no point in all of the years I played World of Warcraft, did I ever give a shit about making sure that I only refreshed my dots when I'd buffs up. I never, ever cared. Ever. Not once. It never even, I was, you know what? My dots are going to wear out. I'm going to refresh them when they're about to run out. That's what I did. Or when I had nothing else to do. I even refreshed over dots that might have been empowered by a buff with a weaker version of itself. Blasphemy! I know, right? Crazy talk. Because frankly, we're talking about such a small percentage of damage. You're talking such a minute amount of who gives a shit. But the pro gamers out there, the pro elite fucks out there. I'm a raider. Okay, those guys. I guess they like the artificial sensation of having extra shit to do. And that's fine. Hey, look, guys, if you're the type of person who really wants to sit there and balance buffs and watch timers and be cons and just have nothing but basically stopwatches all over your screen, watching for that buff, not quite, now refresh, go! You know, that if that's how the kind of game you want to play, okay. I don't. That's fine. But they call it the dumbing down of World of Warcraft. Okay. I need a new chair. This thing is squeaky as hell. Anyway, so you have your dot snapshotting being removed from the game. Blizzard's reasoning is because it's a pain in the ass. Essentially, that's their reasoning. I'm paraphrasing, of course, but essentially Blizzard's like, it's a pain in the ass. And I agree, because I never did it. I never did it, and I didn't care to, but of course, if I was in a guild and I was running, a dungeon or a raid, and the raid leader was noticed happened to notice that I wasn't maintaining the most powerful dots possible. I don't know how he would notice that, but if for any reason he was, I'd be kicked out of the raid. They'd be like, "What are you doing? You're terrible." No, I'm not. I don't care. You're talking about such minuscule bullshit damage. I don't care. Like, you could have done like 5,000 more damage. You don't care. Don't care. Anyway, fine. But the pro elite gamers, the pro elite raiders, they consider the removal of snapshotting as a dumbing down of World of Warcraft. I will use this analogy, okay? So it's like, for the longest time, you were driving a manual transmission vehicle, okay? The car had a manual transmission, and one day you decide the car breaks down. You have to buy a new car. You have to buy a new car, but the only cars you can buy, the only cars available, have automatic transmissions. They're the only cars on the market. You can't even find manual. Let's just say, okay, for sake of argument, you can't even find a manual transmission car anymore. They're all automatic. Would you say that the automatic transmission vehicle is a dumbed down version of driving? I wouldn't. I'd say it's a more efficient in some respects, less efficient in others. Manual transmission cars tend to get better gas mileage if you drive them properly, that is. But an automatic transmission allows the driver to have more, basically pay more attention to the road. It's one less pedal on the floor of the car. You have to worry about, stomping your feet on, and you don't have to worry about shifting every time you're in traffic. Or there's more attention now to the road rather than to shifting gears and whatnot. Granted, it becomes second nature after a while, but the point is that it's less shit that you have to do to get from point A to point B. So, in these people, according to the pro elite raiders out there, if you're driving a manual transmission and then you switch over to an automatic transmission car, it's a dumbed down version of driving. That's insinuating that driving a stick is somehow more intelligent, or means that you have to be more intelligent to pull off, or more skilled, as if it's difficult to do. It's not. It's just more complicated. There's more shit in the way. You know, like, granted, if I'm driving my automatic transmission, all I gotta do is put it in drive and go. I don't have to worry about anything else. So yeah, on that level, it's a simpler thing to process. It's not as complex. I don't have to worry about shifting and putting the clutch and shift and back to. I don't have to worry about any of that shit. I just put it in drive and go. But there's the people out there that purposefully like things to be complex, even if that complexity is more of a handicap than necessary. It doesn't add anything to the experience. Okay. Now going back to dots snapshotting, being, you know, having to sit there and watch dot timers and buff timers and make sure that they coincide, you're not gaining anything by doing that, except for maybe a couple of points of damage here or there. You're really not gaining a whole lot. It's not really benefiting the gameplay a whole lot. It's more of a hindrance, actually, because what could happen is you might refresh your dots with weaker dots by accident. So really, you're not, on average, it's not a plus or a minus. It equals itself out. And that's why what I say is, there's those people out there that really like creating a mountain out of a molehill. They really want to make these systems way more complicated than they are. They take pride in knowing that they can do this impossible task of managing their dots and buffs. And it's like, okay, you're proud of that. Does it in any way help anything? Does it benefit the game in any way? Does it add any value to the game? Not really. No, not really. It just arbitrarily makes something more complicated. Now, again, there's people out there who say that, well, it's fun for them. I don't believe that. I don't believe you. I don't. Okay? I'm sorry. I don't believe you. I think you're lying to me and to yourself. You're lying to me and yourself if you honestly are trying to convince me that sitting there and watching dot timers and buff timers during a fight is fun for you. You're lying to me and everyone you say that to. Now, I would make the argument that by Blizzard taking away dot snapshotting, they're allowing the average dot class player to pay attention more to the fight rather than their dot timers. As someone who used to run a guild and used to lead raids into, you know, the TBC raids and even Wrath of the Lich King raids, as somebody who led raids into these places, I would much rather have my players paying attention to the fight, where they're standing, what they're doing, when to cast, like when the boss is going to be transitioning. I'd rather them being paying attention to that instead of worrying about when their buffs are going to be activating, when they should refresh their dots. You know, sorry, my nose itches today. One of those days. You know, I'd rather them worry about worry about the fight and where to stand and what to do. But no, okay, there's people out there who think, well, no, because by adding things to worry about to increase your DPS, you are then also have to worry about the fight, which makes it harder, which means only skilled people can do what we do, and that makes us good. Now, and this is the argument I always hear. Now, any moron who got to level 100 is going to be able to raid, even though, you know, their damage is going to match our damage, even though they're worse than us. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. If they're in the raid with you, I would assume they're in your guild. And if the person's in your guild and they're in the raid with you, I would assume they're on the same team. They're on your team. They're your guildmate. And I would also assume that you all have the same goal, which is to kill the boss. So, should it not matter if his damage is as good as yours is, if not better, because he doesn't have to worry about, for example, dot snapshotting now? I mean, you're all there for the same reasons. You're there to work as a team and to kill the boss, not to outdo each other in how awesome you are. I mean, you're not competing against each other. You're there working as a team. When I used to run raids, I had a very strict zero tolerance policy against recount. I would kick your ass out of the raid if I saw any postings of recount anywhere on any public channel. You whisper that shit to somebody. I don't want to see it, and I don't want it to be it because it becomes an obsession. It becomes a fucking obsession. People having to outdo each other in DPS, and then what happens is they start pulling to, like, they'll try to, like, anticipate the tank. Just to get that extra damage in, or they'll burst too fast to try to get that extra damage in, or they'll overdo it with the damage and the dots, and might even, back in the days when you could pull aggro, I mean, I know that doesn't fucking happen anymore, but back when you actually had to watch your aggro and watch your damage you're outputting, it got people killed. You know, people we would get wiped like repeatedly because there was always those five or six morons in the raid who had to beat each other in their DPS. So instead of us getting done what we had to get done, which was kill the fucking boss, instead now we have five or six nitwits competing with each other who's got the bigger E-peen. Because, well, my DPS is higher than his DPS. I mean, I'm the better player. No, you're not. And I'll say this, I would much rather have, in my raid, I would much rather have a guy who stays alive the whole fucking fight, but only does 600 DPS versus the guy who does 900 DPS but is dead in the first 4 minutes. Or puts extra strain on the healers because he's a fucking idiot, doesn't know how to get out of the fire, doesn't know how to deal with adds, he just likes to do lots of DPS. And he's sitting there watching his dots and he's watching his buffs and he's making sure that everything. Dude, I would much rather you watch the fight instead of watching to make sure you're squeezing out an extra 10% damage because it means nothing to anybody except for you. It's a selfish endeavor, and I don't give a shit about your own personal wants and needs. When we're supposed to be working as a team, you could take your own personal wants and needs and shove them straight up your fucking ass. Take that shit to the fucking forums where it belongs and take it out of the fucking raid. Self-serving, egotistical bullshit. Sorry if you disagree. I don't give a fuck if you disagree. Make a video on your own channel if you disagree. I'll be sure not to watch it. Because I've encountered this stuff so many fucking times in so many fucking raids where, and not just in World of Warcraft, in a lot of different games, where it becomes a personal competition between three or four individuals, which ruins it for the rest of the raid, and we're not allowed to say anything about that because that's the fun they're having. Well, I'm glad your fun is ruining it for everybody else in the raid. So now what Blizzard is doing is they're making it so that that's not even a factor. And I applaud them for it. And you know how hard it is for me to compliment Blizzard? I applaud them for this. I am thankful that they are taking away something fucking stupid that distracted most players. Prevented most players from even getting into guilds and raids because they weren't good dot snapshotters. Some arbitrarily inflated difficulty on something that was ultimately meaningless in the end. An artificial source of entertainment and fun for people who really. It's just a little personal competition between the. Look, you want to compete with each other, go throw darts and we'll see who wins. Duel each other outside of Ironforge when you're done, or go join an arena. You're competing against your own team during the game. You know, that's like two baseball players, you know, trying to outdo each other in runs scored versus, you know, like, well, okay, though they're trying to win the game, yeah, but at the detriment of the rest of the team in terms of like stealing bases when they shouldn't, or, you know, I got to maximize my run ratio. It's like, that's not how you play the game. That's not how you play the game. And that's not how you play World of Warcraft. You're supposed to work together as a team. No, it's not about working together as a team. It's not about... If most of these guys really wanted to work together as a team, they'd say, you know what, this is good. The dot snapshotting will help. You know, maybe you have a guy in your raid who has really bad eyesight. Maybe he's got poor muscle skill. Hey, maybe he just doesn't give a fuck about dot snapshotting. Maybe he doesn't like running add-ons. Who knows? All right, his personal preference is as important as yours is, right? That's the argument I keep hearing. So if it's all about the team effort, if it's all about working together, then you should be actually happy about the change and say, at least now John can get, you know, his damage, he won't have to be hindered because he's not paying attention to when his buffs are going off. He's still benefiting from the buffs, he's still benefiting from his awesome gear. It's just not now the difference between manual and automatic transmission, where only the manuals, the guys who drive a stick, they think they're uber fucking elite because they know how to run an extra pedal and a shifter, versus the guys who just want to just get where they're going and pay attention to the road while they're getting there and not have to worry about extra shit just arbitrarily put in the way for no good fucking reason. So, I know I'm in the minority on this one, and I don't care. I often take the point of the position of minority in my videos, because you know what? The majority of people out there, typically when it comes to video games, as we've seen, they kind of ruin games, don't they? Yeah, they kind of do. Me, what I want for me. That's what you always hear. And you're like, I don't care about you. And that's the thing. It's like, if we want to play the me game, fine. You want to play the me game where it's all about me and everything I want and wow, okay, then I can play the same game too. I fucking hated dot snapshotting, always did, and it always pissed me the fuck off to the point where I always used to say, why is it that I have dots on the fucking target and after my buff goes off, they're still weak? They should be empowered automatically. They're my magical spells. Magic, because magic, that's a good enough reason for me. Oh, well, that doesn't work for me. I can't use the me reason because I'm asking for something that will allow me to not have to worry about an extra arbitrary piece of nonsense mechanic so that these guys can feel like they have, like, uber skill when really the skill they've acquired is that of watching their add-on tick down. Okay. I'm glad we got that all cleared up. If you like driving a manual transmission car, fine. Drive your manual transmission car. And you know what? When it comes to dot snapshotting, you could still cast your buffs when the buff, you know, you could still pretend when the buff goes off and you're more, just recast them anyway. Just, it's like the cars that are automatic transmission, but they have that little shifter in it anyway. Like, you could still shift gears as if, like, you could pretend like you're doing. And it gives you the pseudo-realism of shifting a car like a race car driver, even though you're not. It drives me nuts, guys. I'm sorry. That is the dumbest fucking thing I've heard people complain about. Dot snapshotting. Asinine. Fucking asinine shit. It's just like, you know, of all the things in the game, that's the dumbing down of World of Warcraft because you can't recast your dots on a target when you've got active trinkets? Ooh! That's some dumb shit, guys. I'm sorry. That's some dumb shit. Anyway, I don't even know who you are anymore. I don't know who you are anymore. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Corpse Slot. I'm kind of a big deal. I'll talk to you later.